Okay, so I kind of do a lot of stuff that makes me lose my save files in a lot of stuff. I reinstall my OS a lot for a variety of reasons. I'm not really gonna get into it. Like, there's hair in my mouth. There's hair in my mouth. Ah! Well, I mean, like, my current installation of Windows is 11 days old, I'm pretty sure. So it happens a lot, but this results in me losing my save file quite a lot. But Terraria, I mean, I don't know how long it's had Claude. I'm pretty sure it's had it for a long time, but it started doing it by default now. And so I'm like actually keeping my stuff backed up to the cloud, and so like I'm actually keeping my save file, and I wanna turn this world into like just builds everywhere, and like it's one of those worlds where you're like, oh wow, I want to go there, check that world out or something. Like there's a lot of stuff, but for now it's pretty small, and I kind of want to just document occasionally, just what's up. So there's some graves over here. I'm just gonna put them in a chest real quick, so that way there's not echo mist all the time. But I was like, hey, I need mist for something, so I just killed myself a lot. And I've been too lazy to clean it up until now. Of course, it's a ghost. So there's not much notable things right now. There's a single base that I am almost done with, one that I'm starting work on, and a little project. So, starting off with the base, you can see I have everyone in their preferred biome, and like the I didn't figure this out. I just looked up like what's the best place to put everyone and whatnot, and I have everyone in their preferred things. Most of them are just in these basic houses that I made. I will give them better houses in the future, but for now this is the only full base that I have. This will look better because apparently, according to a friend. Too lazy to look it up, but soon they're adding the feature to where you can put ropes over platforms, because currently there's just a hole in the middle of the platforms. And that means that if I put the hole here, then it'll consider all of this, and all of this, and then, yeah. All of that a single room, which is too big for a to set your spawn point. So I just did this for now. If they do add the functionality, then I'll make the rope go up all the way. But for now, it's whatever. So this builds currently the three things that I'm working on are all inspiration, like inspired or copied from my previous worlds. This was the first base I ever made, was in a living wood tree. Me and a friend made ropes going up, and then we had like things off to the side, which just had all the NPC houses, and then in here was just a bunch of rooms. And we eventually lost that world due to corruption. It was actually kind of funny because we are also on the edge of the world, but one day we turned on his Xbox, we got on, and then right here was a wall of dirt that extended everywhere. Like all of this mural, everything was dirt. All our NPCs left, which was strange. I'm an occasionally big. We're kind of exploring the dirt. We're like, is this really just all dirt? And then we're like, Party Girl has moved in. We never deleted the save file because the base was intact. So we're kind of like, eh, if we ever want to come back, check out the base, we can. But we did start on a new world. I want to say that if I wanted to, I could just head over to his house and check out the world. But this base is kind of a spiritual successor to that. Turning that idea of being in a living wood tree into a full-fledged base. See if I can find this screenshot. Okay, here's a screenshot. This was the last world I had. I created this little area out of living wood. And I thought it was really nice. I really liked the bridge connecting them. That was inspired by a hospital that I went to one time in Spokane, Washington. Oh, I just noticed that. It kind of had like a glass bridge. I eventually found that when I was was talking to him, but this was also kind of spiritual successor. This was spiritual successor to that build, which then turned into this build. And yeah, so starting out at the bottom, I haven't worked on the bottom yet. I'm not really sure what I want to do with it, but I just have all the crafting stations, and then all of the furniture stations. What is this group called? Like, use a sawmill to make wood furniture. This to make honey stuff. This to make sky mill stuff. You know. A lot of them are over in here right now, and a couple were around the place. This isn't finished. And then here I have the chest room. I am on journey mode because I just prefer playing on journey, honestly. I don't really like grinding at all. And there are some pretty grindy elements of Terraria. And journey just lets me stop doing that. It also is amazing for building because, like, if I want something, I can just, like, boom, 999 wood, just like that. It is so nice for building. And that's what I can't, and, like, you know, that's what I wanted this world to be, just building. Oh, I just noticed that there's dirt right there. But yeah, so because of that, the chest room's pretty empty. Like, potions, I'm too lazy to do anything with these. I'm just like, whatever, I'll just throw them in there if I ever need them. I guess I can take when I'm just collect potions I find in chests until I can duplicate them. And then there's, like, some accessories that are, like, notable ones throughout the game. Kind of a lot of that, but yeah, so that's nothing really interesting down here. This is stuff for the cell phone. I've been too lazy to get it. I went and got the Terra boots and the Zenith, and I haven't really felt like getting the cell phone, as it's not very useful. I pretty much only use it as a magic mirror, which I already have. So yeah, so starting off here, we have the guide and the merchant, which I just now remembered that I was gonna make rooms for the golfer and the zoologist. I wonder if, like, can they move in anywhere here? Golfer, where you at? Golfer, this room's too big. Oh yeah, I'd have to cut off that. Might actually do that right now. I don't know. I'll think about it. Next update video I'll make, later, if I do turn this into a series, later videos I'm just gonna go over what's changed since. I might try turning, I might, like, have the zoologist live in the library and then the golfer right here or something, just that way I can have all the planes, NPCs or whatever, but it's those two is good enough for the pylon. And then, so we have guide's room and the merchant's room. They're the same, except the guide has a exclusive balcony to himself. I would have the merchant have one, but he has the stairs. So I'd say they're pretty equal. Then just kind of stare. I don't really know what to put in here, so I just kind of put in a hollow armor guy with a Excalibur killing the Eye of Cthulhu. Then here's kind of like a living room area. You have two. I kind of thought of, like, my grandma's apartment. I don't think there are any other apartments here, actually. I only have ever been to a different apartment place, but there's, like, lobbies and stuff, and I kind of, like, was inspired by them a little bit. I just need to do that. I was looking down there. I'll get to that. But it's kind of like that. Yeah, and so then over here is the pylon. And I don't really know what to fill up, so I just did the two paintings. And every light here is hooked up to a switch. Because why wouldn't it? And then up here we have the library. There's a little place for the grandfather clock. I mean, it's kind of the same room. They're hooked up the same lights, but yeah. And then there's just two bookshelves. There's a place where you sit down and read the books. I need to get rid of this. This is the librarian's desk. I really don't like how it came out. You can see I just put down living wood and then used actuators on them. But I don't know. Like, I really wanted to put, like, a candle on it or something, but I just couldn't because they're actuated. And I wanted to put a chair right down there, but the chairs are two blocks tall. I don't know. I really feel like this could have turned out better, but I don't know. And then here's the back. I'm too lazy to put stuff in here. This is like storage. You know, she's like doing library and stuff back here. Whoever the librarian is, the zoologist. I don't know. She's on vacation right now, I guess. But up here is my room. Here's my bed, little candle, whatever. And then, so I noticed when I was making my room that there was kind of a pattern where there was the important stuff on the right and the left is just a single pylon, and then just a single grandfather clock. So I tried to break up the uniformity and make it more visually interesting, having important stuff over here also. But like, this is kind of like my personal area part of the room. This is like, oh, if someone's over, we can just hang out over here. I want to sit down on a table and do something. I don't know. Yeah. And then over here is just a place where I can, like, view. You know, obviously I don't sit up here and look at the view because there's nothing to see. But, like, assuming this was a real place, you know, kind of, like, hang out up here. This is my balcony. I can just look at the view down there. Living room is here because I don't really know. I'm not fully done with this. I'm done for the most part, but I feel like there's still some stuff I could do. And then also someone said I should make like a forest down here or something. I mean, that sounds interesting. I'll look and I'll try that. And yeah, I keep seeing like, I can't even show off the almost finished thing without noticing those two stray pixels. Oh my god. And there's another one right there. I mean, just crack that bad. Finally, vines are starting to grow. I was wanting that. You know, this is kind of like an old-timey house. I'd imagine that the guide and merchant are kind of like the kind of people, like, merchant's pretty old, and the guide, I feel like, is kind of a person who would like older style stuff. So that's kind of what I'm going for. And then the golfer and zoologist is kind of dragged into it. So, yeah, last thing is the teleporter. I noticed that there was a floating island right next to it when I was making my balcony. I was like, oh, hey, floating island. And so I was like, hey, I could do something with this. And so I kind of was like, I don't know, maybe these people, like, how they rely on fish a lot. And so they come up here and fish, and there's, like, two little fishy things, whatever. And then a little shelter from the rain. I thought, this isn't centered, as you can tell. This is, like, I thought maybe putting it on the rain cloud would mean something. I don't know. And then that was just because I was making walls that wasn't meant to stay there. And then, there's things. This is, like, little smaller ponds if you don't want to fish in the big pond. I don't know. So then down here is just a balcony for people. It's kind of like another living room. We can hang out, talk to people, look at the view. So yeah. There's also just a pool right there. There's not really much importance to that. I swear I just saw some stray pixels that needs some walls. I'll just go around later, but that's, it's about 13 minutes so far. Oh my god. But that's enough of the thing. So next, this is the closest thing. So you can see this is the teleporter room. This is kind of the starting area. I don't know if I mentioned this, but the starting area, just a bunch of teleporters. To the left is natural areas. So here's hell. It's right on the elevator. I might do something with, like, the area around the teleporter. Make it kind of like a safe place, maybe? I don't know. I'm not really sure what I'll do with hell. And then just the dungeon. I also really want to do something with the dungeon. I forgot that I can't double tap because it kills them. And then just the right ocean. Because if I want to head to the left ocean, I like to use the pylon. And every time I go here, I'm like, wait. Am I dyslexic? This is the left ocean. Oh, no. There's the pool water. Doesn't it look like, doesn't it look like it's the left ocean? Oh, there you go. And then to the right is man-made stuff. So here I was gonna have a teleporter to my base, but there's just a pylon there now, so I don't really need the teleporter there. And then this, I don't really know why this is empty, but this one isn't. This one's also empty. These go nowhere. But the only other one that's hooked up is all bosses. So this, I'm sure I could look for the screenshot, but I don't care. This is kind of like a room area for every boss fight. So here we have King Slime. These chests will be filled up with all of their drops. Which kind of room, like there's a slime room because it's King Slime, trophies, mask, those things. I forgot what they're, what are these called? Oh yeah, relics. Then there's Aya Cthulhu, Eater of Worms, I swear to God, Eater of Worlds, Brain of Cthulhu, Queen Bee, Skeletron, Gearclops, that's his name. Gearclops, I don't even know what that is. How did I get that? I got it earlier, and I thought, for a second, I thought that it was, oh, it's the Don't Starve thing. Okay, yeah, it's the Don't Starve ghost. I thought that was just die for a second. Then Eater of Worlds. I swear to God, Wall of Flesh. So here are a bunch of the crafting stations I mentioned earlier that were missing. You can see there's signs right here for boss, and there's gonna be mini boss later. I haven't really started on the drop since I find that a little annoying. But I was going to start work on the hard mode bosses. But I wanted a transition between the hard mode and the easy mode bosses, and I wanted some cool looking transition, but I couldn't really think of anything. And then I got distracted working on my base, so yeah. And then, that's not finished, that's a work in progress still. And then the other work in progress is the jungle. This is actually a temple. So as of recording this, I started clearing it out. And while I was clearing out, I was like, oh, I should make this video. And then I placed the NPCs there so I could have the working pylon. So these are the underground NPCs. Like, that's kind of like in the thing, like the optimal layout thing. These guys are said to be underground. But underground jungle is underground. And I want this area to be like a, it's like an underground civilization. I didn't think of this. Like, this was taken from my previous world that had the tree thing. I think I might actually still have it in my backups folder. But when I backed my game up, I was just starting work on this area, and I was near finished when I lost it, and so that kind of drained my motivation to play in that world, honestly. And so this, it's kind of like a underground civilization, as I mentioned. These kind of people, I had like a separate story. This is kind of like an evolution of the previous story of this area, but I kind of realized this is similar to the Serpentine from Ninjago Season 3. I might have noticed that I've been watching Season 8 and 9 recently. I haven't seen them before, and oh my god, they are good. But Season 3, they were sealed off because of the Stone Army in Season 2. And then they were no longer sealed, but they still decided to just hang out in the underground. And they had, like, their own civilization. And Scales mentioned, like, they have their own folklore and stuff, and I was like, I could do, like, something like, that's very similar to this. And so, these kind of people, I'd imagine, the hunters of the tribe or whatever are the only people who ever leave the temple. The story is unlocked. I really should have never unlocked it, since you can just use platforms. But since the temple has a lot of traps there naturally, and the, what's her face, the mechanic is here, I thought like these people could be like very not religious, but like, what's the word, I can't really think of the word, but like very past, and like, I can't really think of the word right now, but like they really respect their customs and stuff. And since this is a temple that was later turned into a village, maybe they really like wiring. And so I'm thinking, like, I don't really have, that's kind of just like an idea right now. The only things I have to think, I mean, like, the only ideas I have are, like, the doors are just blocks with pressure plates that turn on and off actuators. That's kind of what I'm thinking. And, like, there, it's a very wire central place. And my previous attempt at this, I had it right here, and then it went down, and then over here was the boss arena for Golem. So I kind of imagined it as, like, Golem was a folklore, like, don't go in there, or else you're gonna have to face Golem. Only the best of the best fighters fight Golem. No one's been able to do it, or something. Maybe one day, some foreign warrior will come set us free from the curse of the Golem, or something. Maybe along the lines of that. But the Golem boss arena was right here, and I couldn't really pull that same thing off without making my own arena, which I might do. But I don't know. So for now, this is just an empty area with not much in it. I will start working on it after I get done recording this. Yeah, that's the only notable things in this world in terms of, like, building and stuff. But I do want to complain about my dungeon. This is the worst dungeon I've ever seen. So, oh, these guys are still mad at me. I believe that I broke all of the shelves to check for water bolts, I'm pretty sure. And then I found it or something, I don't know. But let's just head down the dungeon. Okay, we are officially in the dungeon biome. We're still in the entrance. Actually, I'm going to turn minimap off, because that'll spoil it. We're still in the entrance. There's a difference in wall, but, like, we're still just going down tunnels. We're still just going down tunnels. Still going down tunnels. And then there's a trap. And then there's a trap. And then there's a third pit. And then go down some more tunnels. Finally, a big open room. And then there's more tunnels. Exciting. And then you can see a lot of normal torches. I forgot to do the torch god. And then let's get here. There's just more tunnels. That's all this dungeon is. It's just tunnels. There's nothing else. And then here, we finally exited the entrance of the dungeon kind of thing. Now we have actually, like, dungeon. There's proper fake, I mean, there were fake walls before, but not really, like, kind of this thing. Like, whoa, there's drops. There's, like, enough room for mass amount of enemies to spawn. There was right there, but, like, any other place, enemies just wouldn't spawn that much. And there was, like, a single biome chest. I don't even think I have all the biome chests in here, honestly. Yeah, this is easily the worst dungeon I've ever seen. So, that, I'm just gonna check. I do believe that is everything. I kind of want to do something in the Hollowed with the fact that it's on top of a crimson that I turned hollow since I have biome spread off. I can do that. I kind of want to maybe have another folklore kind of thing about, I think I see some crimson right there, about, like, it used to be crimson, but then something saved us. I don't really know. Again, this is still a work in progress. Oh, it is some crimson. Ah. It's not enough to be considered a crimson biome, but if biome spread was on, then I would have been screwed. Where's the intimidator? I can never find it. I don't know why. CLE. There we go. Turn this all into normal. I just realized that I accidentally grabbed blue solution, not grain solution, but I guess it's fine. Oh, what a great way to end it off with a crash. I've been getting a lot of crashes recently. System object dispose exception cannot access dispose object name texture 2D. Which is, I don't really know why. It's very strange because before recently I've never had Terraria crash on me. I don't think ever. Only issue that I've ever had with it was the corruption that I mentioned earlier. But yeah, so I guess it's over. And I'm gonna start working on the temple. And goodbye.